woman uses so many techniques for data preprocessing, but also you can use a computational training technique. Here, after doing preprocessing, you can have here, for example, a cluster algorithm. For example, using self-organized maps, fuzzy clustering, or also any colony optimization, by example. Then we can have the function approximation algorithms, like neural networks, some genetic programming, for construct the entire system. But this here, for optimization algorithm, use it for design this part of the system. This framework is a general framework that is used from my group to construct almost so many different systems for resolve a different kind of problems. By example, problems in control, problems in pattern recognition, problems in time series prediction, and so many other problems. Here, in the next part, we explain some of the hybrid intelligence systems architectures that, in my institution, are two groups. For in the hybrid intelligence part, that is the group of Professor Oscar Castillo, working more in control and robotics, and in my group, that is, we are working more in pattern recognition and in time series prediction. And we are construct systems like this type. The first, we have the phenomenon of process systems having data from different sources depends on the problem, and have here some preprocessing fields, and then construct different models, model 1, model 2, model T or IN problems, and then join these models as a granular model to solve a problem. This is the space knowledge management that we are using right now. And these models, particular models, can be a fuzzy model, neural network model, even regression model, or differential process models. But in so many words that we are doing, this is different models using neural networks. And how we are construct these models? In the beginning, we are construct the entire model with hierarchical genetic algorithms. Construct the models itself, model 1, 2, and model M, and also the response integration of these models using a type 2 fuzzy inference system. And this construct from this hierarchical genetic algorithm. What is a hierarchical genetic algorithm? Is similar to a genetic algorithm, but the chromosome have a hierarchic form for construct the different number of models, different number of layers, different numbers of nodes, and so on. And also, we are using here for know what type of a fuzzy inference system we need to use here. If Mamdani, Sugeno, or even the type of logic. But as I said before, here we are using modular, but what modular this means, and if we use neural networks models, what is this? Okay, my main research is in modular neural networks. But what is a modular neural networks? There exists a lot of neural network architectures Yesterday, you see a talk, the first talk that you see was indicated that deep learning, and they say, well, one neural network is difficult to capture the behavior of the system, and also they have problems when we use so many layers. But why we use so many layers? Because the problem that we can solve is very complex. If we want to solve a very complex problem, yes, I agree, one network is difficult to solve that problem. Why? Because the complexity of the architecture of the network increases. And what happens when it increases the architecture of a neural network is happening. You have to see in the literature the number of inputs is relatively small. You can solve with only one network. Well, but when the number of input is relatively more complex, the problem grows in the number of inputs and increases the problem of having so many variables in the problem. And then the performance of one network decreases very quickly. And for this reason, there are also in research working in compensation this in some way. The learning of a single neural network over a high dimensional space, that's the problem. We have a high dimensional space that we need to solve, and with one network we cannot do it. In some research work has been shown that the use of multiple neural systems have better performance or even solve the problems that monolithic neural networks are not at all. What is monolithic is using one. And in this case, multiple networks, we can have the ensemble or modular networks like this one. By example, you can have one, two, and three modules, but solving the same task. And this is called an ensemble. But why we use the same network in some senses for solving the same problem? Because we can have here different architectures and have here different learning algorithms and make this like experts. Yes? This is a college ensemble. And the important thing here is how you can manage the decision process. That's called maybe fusion of results, aggregation results, and other things that I will describe later. And there, on the other hand, we have modular approach. How we differ from ensemble, that we have divide the problem in parts. In the previous, we do not divide the problem. We try to solve the same problem in each one and only have like experts. But here we have divided the problem and each part of the modules, each module have some part of the problem. And when we divide the problem, we can have less complexity in each part. Okay, here the approach, we can find networks that uses a strongly separate architecture, that's the important thing. Each network works independently. Each of the neural networks will and train for a specific task. And finally, the decision is based on the results of the individual networks, called algorithms for experts. Here, how we are construct this network and how we can have the results. By example, this is a typical example, very simple sample, but this is the important thing here. We have a complete system that uses for recognize a person. By example, we have here the voice of the person we have here the face of the person, and one recognizes the person by his voice or her voice, and for his face. And by example, this says how the person is, by example, we have 10 persons. This says how is person 2, and this says, okay, it's person 2. Then the descendant says, oh, it's person 2. But if this says person 2 and person 3, by example, this is not agreed, how can I manage this for saying persons? This is important for that uses the information. Depends on how you construct your model. That's very important, because how we can construct that model, okay, having here the knowledge that how doing that. By example, says, okay, I always more easily recognize a person by the voice. Okay, I give this model more relevance than the other model. And this we can capture here and decide who is the person. That's the concept of creating a modular neural network working for solving a problem in the sense of a model. But if this is not a network, this is, by example, a fuzzy system, we can construct here now a hybrid intelligent system, because we can combine a network and a fuzzy intelligent system, by example. And now, the problem here arises in these things. How can we compose the main problem into subtasks, or organize the modular architecture taking account the nature of these subtasks, the communication between models for give their response to the system? Here is very simple, because you say, okay, I did it by voice and image. Here, no much problem. But in other things, we can have more complex decisions to say how can divide the problem. Here, if by example, if you want to do this thing, having the voice and image with only one network, you can construct that system. I see only this, so anybody answer me? Yes or not? We know only one neuron. Neural network.
You see, it's only neural.
But well, you have a large number of persons to recognize. By example, 1,000. You know, so many researchers are researching in databases that have 3,000 people, different people, for recognized by the face or by the face and voice, etc. It's very difficult. You cannot do it with only one neural network. Okay, now I will briefly describe this part of the system. This is the way we are doing. We have here the input data from different sources. This means you have inputs from the environment. These inputs depends on the problem that you are solving. Is maybe from some sensors, or is the face from cameras, or from microphone, if it's the voice, etc. And we need to introduce to the modules that we are constructing, and then the modules try to resolve the problem and have the decision. But for construct this system, we are using this hierarchical genetic algorithm for says, okay, how many models we need? That's what one problem. How many models we need depends on what we are solving. And how many layers even in the neurons, and how many nodes in each layer, by example. And another interesting thing here of how we construct the decision process depends on what we are solving.
Sure.
Because sometimes we can use simple model like the body mode. If you have different experts, you can vote, okay, this tool says, okay, it's the same thing, okay, this is the response. That's the body mode, the body mode. All depends on the application. You can have here only average, for example. But so many problems cannot do it by vote or by average. You need more, because you need capture the knowledge of how the person solved that problem. By example, we are here having this, but we construct and capture the information with a type 2 facile inference system, by example, using a genetic algorithm. Like this. For example, you see before having what type of system is, Mandani, Chicheno, the number of membership functions also that we have in this system, and Swan, and also the type, if here I put type 2 as a system, but why we use type 2 if the problem is really complex? If not, with type 1 as a system we can solve. And also we manage that in the system. By the way, the form our algorithm works is room fills some learning process, and having the site depends in this form. You see here, we select the number of membership functions. If also the input in the membership functions, and if it's 2, 3, or 1 membership function that we are need. And this is all part of our problem, because we do not need to do it a trial and error for. This is for automatically. And having the type 2 inference systems for decide the solution of all of the models. And having here the person recognized, by example. If we are construct a system that we are to have the person recognized. This method I will explain in more detail, a little detail, but from the beginning we have here first the three different stages. The first one is how we can manage the pre-processing of the data that we have. By example, if we have a database in for face recognition, by example, and when that database is too large, it's more easy to do with edge detection. Instead of having the interior image, we can have the edge detection process, and then rate the relevance of each of the modules having this edge detection information, and then given to the network and training the network, and then we can have more less complex system. And the other stage is training these networks for learning the pattern the pattern of the image. And in this work, we divide in three parts the face of the person. Not complete system, but we divide the image. And in this part, we introduce one technique for also uses the fusion of the modules with Suggeno Integral. This is a method that I developed about 5 or 6 years ago. You can see in the literature. It's very interesting for, I cannot have time here for explaining too many questions. Uses has response back. I will try to explain very quickly here. The first part is the set of original image using the edge detector with fuzzy inference system, interval type to fuzzy system we use, by the way, given to the modular neural network. And having learned it, then we have constructed the hybrid system, and this is how the system works. We have the image to recognize, passes to the edge detector, then simulating the modular neural network that we are constructing, then passes to the module for fusion integration to general integral, and then recognize. And this is the general process. We have here the type 2 fuzzy inference system for edge detector. This is at the first stage was interval type 2, not generalized type 2. Right now we are working on the model of general type 2. Well, why we use type 2 fuzzy inference system? Because we can have more, capture more interesting part of the image and give this to the neural network for training. We divide this image in two parts, and we have here the two different modules with the first part, the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. And this network, the network having network experts by recognize a person only for the first part, others, etc. And at the end of the solution of the modules, we have the type 2 fuzzy inference system by Suggeno Integral. This Suggeno Integral is useless for the site when we have different sources of information. We can have as a ponderation of each of these solutions that we have here and give the final solution. Like sets, we have different sets and having different values for each set and say, okay, this one have more relevance than the other ones. For the same one, this have the correct solution. For example, so why do you use this? Because if some people have glasses, for example, and in one moment don't have glasses, the neural network will be confused. And in that moment, the first network maybe don't have the correct answer, but maybe the second one have the correct one, because we don't have problem if the people don't put anything here or in the knowledge. That's why it's one reason that we can divide the English, for example. That's why we are doing so many research on that for capture. Even is very good, by example, when we have the fingerprint, if the person put different in a different way, if you want to recognize the put the interior image, if the people put in this way the finger, the system cannot recognize. But if you do it like this form, maybe we can recognize for the part of the top, for example. That's why we are using this word. Also, we are constructing this type of system, for example, having a large system using or recognize persons with the face, with the fingerprint, or with the voice. This is using for a large database and also for security systems, for example. And this is the hierarchical genetic algorithm, having the input numbers and functions, mandalis, you know, type 1 or type 2, fuzzy rules, and the CDS, the different form of type of fuzzy system for the part of integration. This is like, as I showed before, how we are constructed automatically these ones, and this is the anterior chromosome, and this is the other chromosome. Of course, this is to design, and when the system is designed, this is obviously offline in the process of learning of the entire system. This is, and you have here is different from the previous work, because in the previous we don't have, I decide put only a type 2, but here we can say, okay, is type 2 or type 1 system that we need to use. And this is some smaller recognition systems that we have built by iris, ear, or voice, for example, and having some different. You notice here how different can be the membership functions, depends on the application and depends on the image that we have. This is very difficult to construct directly from scratch in. If we don't have any method, automatic method to find manually these things, or decide if we need something like that, for example. And this is a similar approach. You see here the division that I mentioned, and also division, and also we are doing division in the voice recognition, having a modular hierarchical neural network here. And this is, by example, one architecture that we are constructing for iris recognition, for example. And also divide the number of persons in each module and divide the model, the iris. Now I briefly maybe describe some application of hybrid system using this proposed method, but with other bio-inspired algorithms instead of architectures. By example, in particular, a facilitated adaptation of practical sort of optimization in modular granular membrane methods for hybrid recognition. By example, I don't know how many time I have. Well, I will not describe a modular neural network because I really don't. The proposed in this particular application is applied to pattern recognition based on iris geometric and function to minimize the error of recognition. Here, the proposed method is adaptive. This is important, and I want to explain a little bit. Here we are developing a fuzzy PIOS method and using parameter adaptation. Here the interesting thing is we are in the room adapting C1 and C2. Yesterday I don't really describe the TSO method because yesterday you see the was here yesterday, describe this algorithm, but here I am doing this with adaptation of the practical for optimization, for briefly described for who has not been here yesterday. The practical for optimization was developed by Kennedy and Everhart in 1995. This optimization technique is strongly inspired by simulation of social behavior of animals.